disabilities. But first, Stacy Kohut's life is going downhill fast. The faster the better, actually. Because at the bottom of that drop, there could be a Paralympic gold medal.
I've been a skier since age 2. I was one of those kids that grew up idolizing the Crazy Canucks. Kaborski and Reed were my heroes. And on the weekends, I'd go out and I'd try to simulate what I saw them doing on TV. I had my first motorcycle by age 6 and was racing bikes by age 10 and really, really high-risk lifestyle. I fell off a swing set. It'll be 10 years in March. Ended up landing on my head and breaking my back and damaging my spinal cord. I wasn't going to change who Stacy Kohut was. Stacy Kohut was an adventurous, high-risk-taking person. Being a kid that grew up where falling and picking yourself up isn't such a big deal. I really just approached the back injury and the spinal cord injury like any other injury. And I just tried to pick myself up. I was sit skiing 8 months after I broke my back. I caught an edge, went into a chairlift tower at 40 miles an hour, broke my femur, broke 3 ribs, punctured my lung. 12 months after that, I won a gold medal at the 1994 Paralympics in Lillehammer, Norway. 1998, I followed that up with 3 silver medals. To be a great skier, you must ski all 4 events. And that's what I'm doing. I'll be skiing slalom, GS, Super G, and the granddaddy of them all, the glory event, the one that I seem to excel at, is the downhill. In the downhill, we should reach speeds of over 100 kilometers an hour. If you mess up in a downhill in a sit ski, you die. The extreme nature of what I'm doing makes me so happy to be involved with it because I am pushing the limits every time I go up. I love it.
I'm Ozzie Sawicki. I'm the head coach of the Canadian Disabled Alpine Ski Team, and I'm also the head coach for the 2002 Paralympic team going to Salt Lake City.
Work the rolls.
And wherever you're coming over the pitch, try to stay on the ground more.
Okay.
Stacy's fun to coach. He's very focused. He has a goal. He knows that he wants to be podium, period. And he works towards that.
So I'll meet you at the bottom. I'm just going to watch you off the roller.
I'm on the slopes 5 to 6 days a week. And I'm an A-carded athlete with Sport Canada. And I really take it as a job. I believe that there's got to be 40 to 60 hours put in every week on the sport.
If you were to look in the phone book under CADS, Learn to Ski program is what you're looking for.
We all realize what we're doing out here is goes beyond sport. There's also some social commentary that we're making about what people can and cannot do with disabilities, which is very important.
Tell them to get out there, man.
It's just the same as any other ski racer, disabled or not.
Okay, man. Take care.
The only thing that's missing is a big corporate sponsor to come along and help us.
Yeah. What setting are we on?
It's on number 4.
For a Paralympic athlete, we are so relying on our equipment. With a sport like alpine skiing, the cost is so high that really there has to be some sort of help from somewhere. And what I did was develop a grassroots program where I'm really community-oriented and community-based. So we have people within the Banff and Canmore area that have been supporting me for the last 4 or 5 years now. Everyone from the local baker to the local snowboard shop owner.
Stacy, what's going on?
Don't do that one, dude. What's up?
They've done an amazing job of taking up the slack.
It's going all right, dude.
I'm still ranked top 3 in the world for downhill. Super G, I just scored a nice 4th place. I truly believe I'm the best all-round skier in the world. I have a little philosophy that I say to myself every start of every ski season, and that's I ride for fun, but I race to win. Now going into my third Paralympics, I'm just looking to win every race I enter. And there's no sense in setting my sights any lower than what I've already been. I've tasted gold. We're gonna try to come home with 4 gold medals.